So I'm back. So we have system shut down. It's in a forcing mode. Let's just run it. Or it's not, yeah, it's in a forcing mode, but if it's not running, it can't be in a forcing mode either. But by default, it would be enforcing mode. So we are here again. This is not our system. This is. CD my login user. This is root sudo shell. Search MAVCTS 1014 audit to allow less. These are some insignificant stuffs. Okay, let's log in. I just hope this stuff doesn't crash. Unrelated. Here we have data convert. Grab data convert. Add name local. It wants to basically be able to create local. Let's just quickly set a 4-0 now, so that we know something. So it wants to create local nano my login user TE, and then dset data convert. So it wants to create local. Local is dconf home t, so let's just search for dconf home t. W, and we need to basically see something that creates dconf. Here we have something that creates dconf. So now we go back. For data convert, gset data convert. Actually, all these programs need to be able to and then it's just gset data convert, just changes. All these programs need to be able to do this. So this should be fixed. Solved. Let's go back and see what else we have. So we fixed this one. Okay, SE module B. Actually, first let's just make F. TG set data convert. Okay, where is TG set? Data convert and fix that. Okay. Log off. I see module B. Maybe it was the VDA agent that caused the stuff to crash. Not sure. Let's just have a look here and say today. Probably also say user ABC. Maybe that's something if people's chatting. To make sure it's not crashed, it's just taking a long time. Because it has a use list till and 1000 var log messages ordered to allow nothing. Alright, so kill all, clean up, ls all c temp rm rf temp pulse audio and then shut down H now. Just need to make sure that so it seems that we actually were able to crash the system via VD agent or something. But it seems to be the policy. So 10:23, let's see if we're clean at 10:23. Let's first cd to my login user, and then sudo shell looking at 10:23. Accept the two names and that LXC one. This one. Okay. See my login user. And let's just pretend that nothing happened. We're in a forcing mode. Let's just verify that. Again, force. We're in a forcing mode and we're just logging in. No big deal. No big deal at all. We're just logging in. And we have an ABC denial already. So, it's also trying to create something. And dconf home tether. So it's trying to create something in there, but I don't know what it is. I don't know what it is. But at least it seems that VD agent is now done. Log out. Okay. Sucks so bad this. Don't audit that excessive use of don't audit sucks really bad because basically you're forced to do as in module DB. Okay, let's log in again. Hopefully we can see now what creates it, but nope. Christ. Probably need to actually reboot for that to happen. So we're forced to just do that. However unfortunate that is. And not just that, but I'm pretty sure, let's just do it the simple way. It's probably just as in module DB, or actually an add name wouldn't be don't audit it, but still, we just should do it anyway. So. So I'm just going to do that. I would like to have a reasonable solid base, if possible. I would like that. So that you basically, if you boot the system and you log in, then nothing is wrong. So we're there, we cleaned up. We can basically reboot, can't we? Okay, let's log in. CD my login user CD shell. C cd my login user I'll search ts1031 order to allow less. Now we get all these stupid don't audit messages again. Okay, let's log in. Go through this again. Firewall. XP. And here we have that admin. So now we know what it's going to do there. It's basically all. So we have DCF data convert add name. So let's just grab data convert. Convert and see what it creates there. Share. Oh man, it's just creating everything. So, and I should have known that, of course. What creates, we're searching for data home T. This is actually right there, boom. And then GSAP data. Boom. Word. And then just basically put this below. Actually, let's just put that where it belongs, local share. And then just change that to reflect. Like that. Nice. Need to clean this up. Make apps. Install. Log off. Verify. Eventually we really need to be clean on boot. Okay, log off. And then the skills. Clear. Let's look at this stuff again. See if something else happens when we actually log off. This is loud. Nothing happened. Shut down. Reboot now. And let's once again reboot. Until we're clean. But of course, it's probably not clean yet. Because if you think about it, if it creates this local share, then it doesn't do it for its health, probably. I guess that's what I would expect. I would probably expect it that it creates something in there. And if so, then we will see that right now. Okay, what do we have? Yep, oh no, that's not it. Since it's just creating local share for its health. That's a good reason to create it. LSRZ home my login user, and then just list it. And then list local. List share. Okay, so I guess it just created that for its health. Peace out. Grab 10, 12. So if that's true, so this requires some extra testing just to make sure that things work the way they should. Let's log off. So basically now we've loaded the policy without the silent denials. Let's kill and clear. And move this stuff. Shit down again. Hopefully now we're clean on a reboot. That will be neat. N44. Let's see if we're clean. Except, of course, the add name for the named conft, which is a bug. This one is expected. That's and we can ignore this one. Okay. Login. No, as a troubleshoot. That's good. That's a good sign. We're clean. So we actually were able to log in clean. Now if we log out and log in again, I'm not going to remove, or actually I'm going to remove. Log out. Basically, three tests. Kill all processes. Clear. And then. Basically, three tests. One clean boot from boot, login from boot, then a login after you logged out. And then with the directory removed. Seems still clean. Still clean, and now just log out without removing any directories. Just log out and log in. So now I can, with pretty much certainty, say that the user can just log in fine. Now let's just test the shell, the terminal. Get attributes. Let's just have a look at those. Just get an attribute of all the just getting attributes of all the in the scripts. Can you believe that? SE info attributes grab init init scripts domain type init script file type. So we're just going to copy this and we're going to cd my login user. Actually yeah, I'm here. Nano my login user TE. We're going to change something where we had it up. Yeah, it's here. Just for executable, it's not actually. So what we're going to do here is we're going to require attribute. In the script file type. And then just basically remove this. And then just basically allow get attribute my login user T and then file get attribute. Let's just do that and then init rcxact. This can be removed, these two. You kidding me? Oh yeah, that's fixed. Okay, so that's done. Make that. See what it makes. All that. We should take care of that. And now doing outsource again, see if in the meanwhile anything else popped up. No, nothing. And then just, yeah, we have that one ABC to now. Dismiss that, see if that pops up anything. Nope, doesn't. We can't, of course, still open the SE Troubleshoot program, but we can dismiss. ID. And that's all. And there we have already this ID. Gave us some ABC now. Mail spool. It wants to get attribute of mail spool, and that's for checking mail. So mail spool. Where is mail spool T? It wants to check your mail. Okay, what's the next one for mail spool T? And then I'll just allow my login user T mail spool T the get attribute. And just install that as well. Let's just close this terminal. Open it again. A little bit more snappier. This one is allowed, this one is allowed, mail spool T is allowed. Oh, there's a file actually. And it just wants to read it though, I'm pretty sure. Mail spool T. So this is actually a file, and I'm pretty sure that it wants to read. Open. Read. Get local mail, so that we can basically later decide whether we actually want to allow that or not. Let's send a message. Echo test. Pipe that into mail as test my login user. And just have new mail. So now it's able to determine that I had mail. Mail command not found. I have ABC denials. Why does it actually, and then systemd, warranty. Let's just 740 to see what it does. 740, see what it all needs. Yeah. So it actually this is actually what it needs. Excellent. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to transition on Sendmail. If I look here, unless that, see what's going on. So this is bash getting attributes of init RC. This is old. Actually, that should be old. Yeah, it's old. Let's go all the way below. And here you can see that the mail program. Aha, so it's not actually mail itself, but it's... So that sucks. So to be able to use mail, you're going to need access to temp. That sucks. Unless you confine the mail program. But the mail program actually here we have GNOME shell doing something, add name to dshell data home to the application state. So it's creating an application state there. Or application state file. Let's see, on my local system, lsrz, local share, gnome shell, and we have an application state file there. We have an application state file there, so we can take care of that. G-shell. And that is basically data and T. And it wants to add a name here. Add name. And then it wants to create a file. Create a file. Let's take care of that. So let's see where the mail command, if that's actually... Let's see that. Where is mail? Where is mail? User bin mail, ls of z user bin mail. And it's a link to mail x, so that's cute. So we can actually do that. So we can actually create policy for mail x. Save this. FC. And then it's basically, oh, we don't even have to add a file context. So we can basically go on below and just create a policy there. So mail. And then just do the following. Paste that in, and I'm just saying xmail. I'm just trying to use a name that, and I'll just also call this xmail. I'm trying to use a name that's not already in use, just to be sure. So this is sendmail exact t, which we need to require type sendmail exact t. And that's basically it. And then just use your xmail. And it's run by normal user. Normal user runs sendmail exact t. Yeah, sendmail exact t. Normal user transitions to xmail. And a normal user does not need to inherit resource limits and stuff from xmail. Oops. Yeah, I hope that it's the same mail exact t. And then also fix the transition. Then we can basically decide whether or not the user can actually use it. Sendmail exact t. We could do that anyways, but this makes it also this hopefully at some point at the eventually allows us to prevent access to temp at all and still be able to use some of the functionality. Let's make sure that the file and temp is gone. And it's all the temp. Guess it's gone. I'm sure it's let's see if we're clean at 11:08. How much is... Let's try that again. Let's see what we have. Oh, actually, let's just... Auto to allow that. Auto to allow. Yeah, unless that. Just to be sure. Now we have some nice stuff. So this, I thought that was Silent Beat Night. Let's have a look. I don't output it that. Right. Let me audit socket. For now, disallow that. And we'll just need to require these as well. For now, just disallow sending to audit log. Okay. What else do we have? Here we have some stuff. So it's actually creating stuff in temp. So now there's also another change in scenario here. Where is MailSpooky? And the next MailSpooky. So here, let's just keep it on good attributes. And instead of get local mail, check local mail. So that it doesn't actually read it. Okay, so let's add this, these rules here, and let's change them. So we have mail spool search get attribute. This might actually just be able to remove that altogether. So it's a home girl, get attributes. And if you want to search user home girl, then you also need to search user home routine. So I'll also add that. Home routine. And use dev.ts. Now there is also a lot of stuff related to that, but we'll see that later, I guess. Or if you have use dev.ts, do we have something here? Car file. Dev.ts still. Not sure. We'll see. I'm not going to go jump to conclusions. So what we need is a new type for our temp stuff. So type mail x temp t. And this is a file type. Type attribute. Mail x temp t file type. It's also a temp file type, and it's also use temp type. And then basically we need to allow actually first allow it search temp search get attribute temp, but also write write remove name, add name, so that should be it. And then basically this is the file, so this is mail x, was it mail x? Yeah, oh it's actually XML. Empty, and then we need to take out type transition. Type transition, and then this type. Empty, and then file transition to XML. And we can use a file name. So let's take care of that. Okay. Let's just save and exit that. Go back. Build that. Install it. Actually, I forgot something, because I just want to make some things, figure some things out. This, for example, see whether that's actually needed. And if it is, then we'll see that. Our search, we're at 1116. We're clean. Let's just get out of this terminal, open it again. Doesn't seem to be finding the mail. But it's nothing to do. Let's SE module DB. But maybe it's just not. We'll see. Let's send a mail. Now we already have some stuff here. Still doesn't see the new mail. These are denied. Let's. And now it sees the mail, so you actually so yeah, actually this get attribute is needed. S- So let's go back. That's my male stuff. And this is actually not just for X session, this is really just for everyone. But I think this should be enough because we're in enforcing mode, I think. Oh no, we're in permissive mode, aren't we? Get enforce and in permissive mode. We're at 19 now. Let's just run ID again. And it doesn't actually show me again. Let's send a message again. Then run ID again. It still don't show me the message. Then one more. Why don't I see whether I have mail or not? Quit. Set attribute. Well, I'll be damned. All the way below. Let's put the file set attribute, I guess. Yep. Set attributes. Make F. So this is a small project, or at least for now, just checking the mail. But you need to be able to send local mail as well. So that's another story. So Let's just remove some stuff, see how that affects us. Mail and this. No mail. Let's see how that affected us. Didn't affect us. And Zetern is doing some things. Let's grab Zetern. Zetern is actually creating a file in temp. So go to Zetern. And just add it below here. So search get attribute. Temp file. There search get attribute. And then write Zetern temp t. And then make a type transition. Type transition Zetern temp t. Zetern temp t now temp t file Zetern temp. And then just basically create types. Type Zetern temp t type attribute Zetern temp t is a file type, but it's also a temp file and a user temp type. Temp file. User temp type. Okay, so we took care of that as well. So that's just small steps. There's so much to do. It's just basically inconceivable. So we close that. Let's open it again. Let's see if we have something recent. Seven. And this is all not interesting. Just close this again. Let's send an email, local mail. Let's open up the terminal. ID. Why isn't it showing me that I have mail? Might be related to password. Nah, it's not, because we're in permissive mode. Should just work. and it just doesn't work. So, that doesn't work. Mail. We have a text message here. But nothing significant. Quick. And now I, all of a sudden I have mail. Yeah, right. Let's just close this. Okay, so we're clear, but now let's send a force one. And you'll see that it just doesn't work somehow. That something is denied for some reason. Okay. Permission is denied. What do we have? Searching. Possible T. Yeah, fast spool T, yeah, it needs to be able to traverse fast spool T to get to mail spool T. Okay, so now that we have that, let's just try that again. Okay, let's see what ABC now we get now. So now we have that receiving mail, reading mail, done. That just works. Mail, delete, quit. And any other receiving mail for deleting mail? No, doesn't look like any. But we have a file right here. So G shell in this data home T, wasn't it? Yeah, data home T, and it wants to actually write to that file, right? Okay. So now we can actually just read mail without actually ourselves having access to temp. We can still access temp, but we can, but our program can, but we just not us. So just send another mail. Just to see. There's one one. Press some enter, do some IDs. Empty the read, yeah, we don't want that. That was for the LS, so it still looks all fine and dandy. But for some reason, I'm just not getting a notification about my mail. I'm not going to do that. Not getting a notification about my mail, so let's just leave that for now and wait. So I'm going to do something. We're going to try and fix the issue of reading process state. So what I'm going to do it now is I'm going to declare an attribute. I call this attribute my login user process, and I'm going to assign this to each and every process declaration. Well, I'll be damned. Why? And that's basically done this way. And I'm just going to look for type. Probably better off by just so here we have a type. This is not a process type. This is. Basically, so that we can basically allow the user to see its own processes. But not anything else. then you later you can decide for yourself whether you want to make that tunable or not. I'll show you where we'll see where you can do that. Oh, conditionals, whether you want to make it conditional. But it seems to me that this shouldn't be a problem to allow. Basically, what you can do is make the execution of the shell conditional. Just basically, if you don't allow a user to execute a shell, then yeah, you can't run ps or top anyway. So there might be scenarios where you just don't want your user to execute a shell. If you have some kind of kiosk machine, then you don't want to allow that user to open a shell. So it makes perfect sense to basically make that tunable. We can do that, but now is probably not a good time because we're still just making the defaults work, and this probably also not a good time to actually do what we're doing now. We're just getting ahead of ourselves, but it's a Saturday. I don't really feel like getting into a big project, and some of the things that we have to do, like for example confine Nautilus, if that's a huge project, because then you get into all kinds of stuff, like for example thumbnailing, because well, oops, because well, if you're opening Nautilus, then it's going to try and thumbnail your photos and stuff like that. So there's a lot of dependency, so to speak. That's really something I kind of don't feel like doing today. But I might, but let's just do this first. So we're just classifying all our process types. We're just saying, okay, these types are my login user process types. That's what this currently is about. We declared that attribute, that classification, so to speak, and then we're assigning it to the types that it applies to. Thereby classifying it. And this also can make our policy very much simpler. But it's also for later. But we're just trying to achieve something now, currently. Eventually you also want to use these attributes to basically simplify your policy, clean it up. But at this point, that's the least of our concern. We just want to make it a little bit usable. get ourselves a base to work on. I can give you one example of how to simplify, and I will do that because that will save us time as well. This is so much work to do. Incredible. So much to confine. Really shouldn't rush it. Maybe the process monitor might be nice. System monitor might be nice. Reasonable, simple thing to do. We're almost there. We have mill, and that's it. Yeah. So now we basically classified all our processes, my login user process. Now let's go below where I know that Dbus wants to get process state of all our processes. So we had a long list here with all each and every type, but instead we can just basically make one rule that applies to all our processes. And by doing that, you can basically remove all these. So thereby simplifying or removing a lot of rules. And also making it, making little less mistakes, because it's automatically added. Yeah, it's the same stuff. Search, but here it actually also gets attributes for some reason. So let's have a look. Yeah, get attribute. So we'll just keep that, but only for get attribute for some reason. And it, well, we can actually, let's just remove that and see if we can reproduce that. Nah, actually no. What we could also do is just indeed remove it and just allow get attribute everywhere. Let's just do that. So we'll say here get attribute, and also here get attribute. But now what we can also do is basically do the following, and then go up all again, up again. Actually, let's just do that in an existing rule. So this is, for example, but actually here. Add a get attribute here. Let's add a get attribute here. Doesn't, might not make full sense, but so what we can do now is basically I'll add it here, and I'll add a comment. Read all my login user process states. And then just add that here. And then just change this. Then just basically make the my login user the source, and the target is my login user process. But on the same, at the same time, also get rid of everything else. And And so that's basically a don't add it, don't you can basically you could probably basically we'll just make it simpler. Allow off don't audit my login user t domain and then the search and get attributes. Hopefully that'll get rid of that. Let's see. Let's build that. But we have allow, so that was a typo right somewhere. Where did I? And this also can be removed. Oops. So we also need to allow read. And prevent read here, but I have a typo, and that's this one here. I didn't close it. Let's see if. Having any mail yet? No, it's not showing me whether I have mail or not. Get enforce. So we're enforcing. Let's see if we have any recent AC emails. Nothing serious. So let's just do that. PS out and see what happens. Let's so it lists our processes. It does, really. But we're missing some permissions here. So let's see. And it's showing a lot of stuff now, but we need to basically only look at, alright, this is our process to get attribute. So the context is basically done with the get attribute, so we need to go back. And change that. So, don't add a domain. Process get attribute. And allow that. Right, let's just remove this here. Process get attribute. So something like this, but we need to probably require a process get attribute. Require class process get attribute. Not sure if we need to require it, but I'll do it anyway. 7, 5, 8. Let's see if we're clean. Not really, but quite. So let's try this again. Clear screen. PS out. So we're asking for all processes. Probably only getting our own. So that's neat. Let's have a look at the AVC stuff. So this is the git attributes. The git attributes. And we have CPU in line. A read. CPU online. So we can basically, what we can do is simplify this, because just simplify it. If we just deny get attribute, then we're set. Okay, so it's CPU online, so let's have a look at CPU online. Can we just grab grab our CPU and then user share to Linux dval include, and that's kernel layer, I'm sure. So dev relabel CPU online dev read CPU online. That basically so we can basically consider allowing that, but make a note that it's related to doing a PS. So where's my CPU online? Yeah, sorry. So let's make a note here, or not note, but and then this basically get attribute open so that it can read that file. And then type CPU online. So you can read that file. Although it doesn't really seem to need it. So we might want to make a note of that. Better to make notes than to just add it and without a note. That's something I learned about documentation, and although I'm of course still not very good at documenting my code or my policy, this is not no code, I know some of the reasons why it's better to just document excessive than not documenting at all. That's just sure, there's also issues with excessive documenting, and you should also make sure that your messages, your documentation messages also make sense. your comments. And that can be approved. So we took care of this stuff. But now we have other issues, like for example, Top. So Top does show our stuff, but we might need we might need a submission, so let's have a look. And that's 12:04. These aren't related. Actually, we don't need anything else, so we're now dealing with PS Aux on Top in a proper way. So that's cool. Now, just keep in mind that these are only my own processes, so you can't read other users' processes. So you don't have to worry about that. And PSX, just your own processes. Let's see if the sound actually caused ABC denials. Nope, none. That's nice. So yeah, we took care of that. Now, also where we But we are getting ahead of ourselves if we do that. But we could also basically don't audit any attempts to list directories and stuff like that and files, so that basically you don't get any ABC denials for stuff that you basically don't want your user to do. So I think I'll just leave it at that for now. We did some small things. We did the mail, and I don't understand why mail is not actually show me that I have mail. Send a mail. But for some reason it just doesn't notify me. Ah, now it does. So I have to do some other command. Anything related to that? Nope. Nothing related. So the mail just works, the reading mail. Of course, we still can't send mail. But yeah, so we're clean. So as a module, we remove some of this stuff and then just do one more run, simple run with the things that we did check. And make sure that we don't get ABC denials, and we won't get ABC denials probably. So we're at 12:08 now. Make sure we clean. clean yet. And we get a... Oh yeah, and we don't need to allow that. We need to basically silently deny these later. At some point. 9. Are we clean? So we're clean. So let's just do the whole thing. Log out, log in. Check mail, see processes, the whole thing, or at least the things that we did take care of. So we're logging in here. And we have an ABC denial. Let's dismiss that, we'll look at it later. Open the terminal. Let's just send a mail. Check our ID. Let's ls. Let's ps out. Let's stop. We're getting ABC denials, as you can see. And let's just have a look at what we have. This one we can allow. Shell data into. That was a file probably. Yeah. Shell data into file read. Now as for the others, let's have a look. PS is reading pit max. Top is reading also, so they're both reading that and reading utemp. Top is also reading utemp. So with regard to those, we're going to fix that. And we're going to do that in that same block so that we know that it's related. Where did I leave that this here? So we have CPU online, but we also have syscontrol kernel T. A file that needs to be read. And then also utemp. And I just require this one. Make unknown type utemp. Oh yeah, that's right. Utemp key, of course. And we still have an unknown type. What's reading the top is reading utemp. Yeah, utemp. And it's not utemp t because the type doesn't exist, it's inact rc foreign t. So we're going back. There's no utemp t. I'll make a note here, top PS. Oh shit. Sorry. I need to finish this episode. But there's always something to be done. Yeah, so this should take care of that. As a module. PD. Log out. Do the stuff again, all over again. And the green shell is pretty 100%. That's still the case. 42%. 17. 12. Okay, so that's fine. Log off. So now we're basically exposing everything again. I just wanna see if there are related ABC denials with regard to the things we just added. Nothing. A lot of debugging, testing. See if we have anything related. I know it's logging a lot of stuff, but most of it's just unrelated. This is all unrelated. This is all unrelated. All unrelated. All unrelated. Here we have something that we need to add. All these good attributes. Now to have a look at. Make sure that they're all seem to be all done out. So yeah, we took care of it. Killing my hard drive by every time compiling this policy. But okay. Like compiling it a million times. Okay, so I'll log out. Tina 20. The cleaner 20. So let's log in. But we can simply just deny all this. If we just deny access to, and there we have an AC now, straight up. We simply deny access to run the shell, then we're done. Then he can't PS, and he can't read mail, none of it. So we can just make that conditional very easily, and that's because everything else runs confined. So that's what makes this possible. The fact that everything is confined and restricted makes it so that we can basically simply make stuff conditional, because the user itself cannot run well, let me think about that. The user itself cannot run stuff directly but that's only for example if the user if you just for example toggle the boolean that disallows local login and SSH login, then he can only the user can only log in via GDM, and via GDM the only way to get to a shell is to execute the GNOME shell. Other shells are currently labeled with the generic shell type and you won't be able to execute them. So if I basically try to execute Xterm, then I will be denied access, and I'm not sure if it's in the list. Yeah, here, yeah, Xterm, and see, deny access. So you won't be able to. You will only be able to access the terminal via via GNOME shell, GNOME terminal. That's the only way. Top. Let's see what AZ now we have. We do have now one for executing bin. This is allowed, and here we have a lock for init RC of RMT, so we need to allow that as well. But only for initRC. So yeah. Still, it keeps coming new ABC denials. They keep on coming. But this seems to be it now. And then let's once again send a mail. And then just basically do some CDing, CD desktop, CD back, CD documents. Back when am I getting my email ID LS, this will produce ABC denials, and now I get that mail D quit, and now see this one is producing an ABC now, but we can ignore that. So that's basically it. I'll leave it here. It looks nice so far, I think, but I'm easily satisfied. All right.